We all obviously want to have the fastest internet connection possible, and also know that we're actually getting the speed we're supposed to. And while it's easy to test your internet connection using something like speedtest.net, you should also know how to test your connection between devices in your own home network, for multiple reasons. For example, if you aren't getting the internet speed you want, you'll be able to rule out any local bottlenecks. Or if your internet speed is fine, you still want to know that all your local device connections are fast, like for streaming games from your PC to your TV. Fortunately, there are tools out there that make it extremely easy to test your local network speed, and I'll be mainly going over the easiest one, which is really easy. Though I can quickly mention other tools, even though we won't be discussing them all. One is called iPerf, it's short for Internet Performance, which is a command line tool and does have a lot of advanced options if you need them, but setting it up can be a pain. There's actually two versions of it, iPerf 2 and iPerf 3, and unlike the names suggest, iPerf 3 is not simply a newer version, they're both actively being developed separately. Another super rudimentary method is to simply do a file share between two computers and copy a huge file to see how fast it goes. But with that, you're limited to the speed of your hard drive or SSD, and I found that setting up a local file transfer between the computers is often a pain, especially if they're not the same operating system. But the third option is the one I'll focus on today, and I myself only found out about it recently. It's called Open Speed Test, and there are several reasons I think that it is the best option I've seen so far. I was actually originally going to make this video about iPerf, but when I found this, I had to start over because it is way better for most people. But before we get to that, I've got something else that's great for most people. Today's sponsor, Ugreen, and their really cool RevoDock Pro series of USB-C hubs and docking stations. For example, here's the Ugreen RevoDock Pro 210, which is a 10-in-1 docking station, and the RevoDock Pro 313, a 13-in-1 docking station. The RevoDock Pro 210 takes your laptop's USB-C port and expands it into two HDMI ports, a 5 gigabit USB-C port, one USB-A 3.0, and two USB-A 2.0 ports, plus 100-watt power delivery input with 85-watt pass-through to charge or power your laptop, RJ45 for internet, and an SD micro SD card reader. Ooh, that's a lot. With the two HDMI ports, you can hook up two displays simultaneously, each running at up to 4K 60Hz. Or a single display running at 8K at 30Hz using HDMI port 2. Though the configuration will depend on your operating system in terms of being able to extend versus mirror them both. And if you want to do even more, there's the RevoDock Pro 313, which is a 13-in-1 docking station, so buckle up. This one's also got two HDMI ports plus a display port, and for USB ports, there's one 10 gigabit USB-C, two 10 gigabit USB-A, and two 5 gigabit USB-A ports. It also has a 100-watt power delivery input with 85-watt pass-through, an RJ45 Ethernet port, an SD and micro SD reader, plus a 3.5mm audio port. And yes, you can use all three DisplayPort and HDMI ports simultaneously for up to triple 4K monitor output. Again, with the configurations depending on whether you're using Windows or macOS. So if you want to maximize the potential of your laptop's USB-C port, check out the links in the description to learn more about the Ugreen RevoDock Pro 212 and RevoDock Pro 313. And with all that being said, let's continue. Now, as for why I consider Open Speed Test the best for most people, first of all, it's free and open source, which is always great for obvious reasons. Next, it's available on virtually every platform through the native app stores. So in addition to the option of just downloading the .exe file, you could just get it from the Microsoft Store, the Apple App Stores on iOS or macOS, Google Play for Android, Snap Store for Linux, and more. I consider this a huge plus because it makes it super accessible. Not everyone wants to figure out which .exe version to download, and also you get peace of mind if you don't like running unsigned executables, because programs from the native app stores are always signed. And of course, you can still download the standalone .exe if you want. In that case, there's no installation required at all. You just run it. But finally, of course, the most important one is how easy it is to use. Once you have it installed, it will be called Open Speed Test Server, and after you run it, it'll show you a local IP address and port to connect to on any other device. You do not have to have it installed on anything else. It only needs to run on the one computer acting as the server. Then on the other side, it just works as a web page. This is a lot different from something like iPerf, where you not only have to run it as a server on one device, but also as a client on the other. With Open Speed Test, once you connect to the page on the other device, you just hit start, and it does a test of upload and download speeds, and ping and jitter. And to go again, you just would refresh. Now, even though the interface is dead simple, you can actually actually use some more hidden advanced features and settings by adding parameters after a question mark to the URL in the browser. For example, I can run a stress test by adding to the URL *stress=low to run a continuous test for 5 minutes. But there's a bunch of other parameters, like for setting the amount of parallel connections, changing the amount of ping samples, running the test without having to click start, and more. There's a list of them with examples on the main GitHub project page. Now, one thing I noticed is that, at least in my case, where I have 10 gig local connections, not all of my devices can even push the full 10 gigabit, apparently. This probably won't be an issue for 1 gigabit with most people, though. For example, if I run the server side on my desktop, which is my most powerful device, when testing from my MacBook, the download speed is basically right at 10 gigabit. But the upload speed is a lot lower. But that must be because of a limit on the MacBook. Because if I do the reverse and host the server on my MacBook and test from my desktop's computer, it's the opposite. The download speed is slower because the MacBook can't push out the data fast enough, I guess. But the upload speed is, again, back around 10 gigabit per second. Though, as I eventually discovered, it could also be for a different reason. I'll go over that later. So if you're just looking to test the maximum speed your network can handle from one point to another, just look at whichever is faster, upload or download, though this still provides useful info about your devices too. If you aren't getting a certain internet speed you expect on one computer, but you are on others, it could be that device is slow even on the local network, which this could reveal. Now, as for how reliable it is in terms of testing the speed, I would say pretty reliable. For example, I compared it to iPerf 3 running on my iPhone, because apparently there's an app for that, but it only works as the client. Then I ran the server on my desktop. The results were similar enough where I would chalk it up to just minute-to-minute fluctuations in the Wi-Fi speed. You can just see what they were here. Even within the same tool, the results would differ, so it's not probably the best test here. Then I installed the OpenSpeedTest Docker container on my Synology NAS, and here there was a pretty major difference between the tools. From my desktop with OpenSpeedTest, the download speed was only around 2 gigabits per second, and the upload speed maxed out at around 8 gigabits per second. But then I tried my MacBook, and it had a download speed of 9.8 gigabits. And this was all through the same switch and stuff, by the way. As a sanity check, I ran a test with iPerf 2 from my desktop to the NAS, because there are Docker images for iPerf 2 and 3 also, and it showed a max around 9.5 gigabit. Way higher than the measly 2 gigabits per second open speed test was showing. This sort of clued me in that something might be weird with my desktop connection, and something was causing certain network connections to slow down. And I actually figured out part of it was because of how Windows handles network adapters if you have Hyper-V virtual machines. It kind of routes all your traffic through a virtual switch first. So I was able to disable that, and boom, okay, now the download is at least higher, closer to 5 gigabits per second, and the upload speed is at around 9 gigabits, closer to what it has been. I tried figuring out what else could be causing the slowdown, but I have yet to figure that out. But hey, it did let me know that something was potentially slowing down my connection, and iPerf wouldn't have revealed that because I guess it's not web-based, it's more direct, so it might have bypassed whatever was slowing it down. So this could be a nice tool in the toolbox for diagnosing certain network issues, even if you do usually use something like iPerf. Oh, and I should point out that you don't need to only use OpenSpeedTest for local home network tests. More advanced possible uses even include hosting a version of the app as a widget on your website so users can test their speed, or for setting up a speed test server on a company network so employees can check their speed to the company servers, either from their office or when connected via VPN, for example. Another idea could be if you pay for a remote virtual machine in the cloud, you could run it on there and check your connection speed between that. And sure, a lot of that could be achieved with other software, but again, the main benefit is it doesn't require any client-side software, so you or any users can just access it whenever. That also makes it a lot easier to test all your devices quickly. So yeah, if you ever thought about testing your local network speed but were turned off by the usual complicated tools out there, hopefully you're as excited as I was. Thanks again to Ugreen for sponsoring. Definitely check out their RevoDock Pro 212 and 313 docking stations and the rest of the Ugreen RevoDock Pro series. Links in the description. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I was talking about how to avoid pretty much 99.9% of malicious EXE files on your computer. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.